There are a couple of myths about amino acids that people often believe, and they're not true. So one is that we have to carefully combine plant proteins at the same meal. And this came from the early 70s with Frances Moore LePay's book, Diet for a Small Planet. And she turned around that myth 10 years later, said, hey, that's not true. We don't have to carefully combine two things. Although we often do combine, for example, our peanut butter and our bread, but this isn't essential. So you don't need to worry about that one. The other myth is that plant protein is poor quality compared to animal protein. And this myth arose largely because of the studies on rats that were done in the 50s and 60s. And rats are little furry animals that grow very, very quickly, doubling their weight in a few weeks at the beginning of their lives. And these studies put us on the wrong track because humans do not want to double their weight that quickly and they don't grow fur. So plant protein works wonderfully for humans. And we can get protein, some of the higher protein foods are all these different lentils, beans, legumes from the veggie meats. People can use peas, sprouted lentils, seeds. There are plenty of good sources of all the amino acids. What we do need to often learn when we're putting together a good vegan diet is to include legumes, beans, peas, lentils in different ways. And so that's the trick. And we want these because of amino acids such as lysine, tryptophan. They're very valuable and they also have iron and zinc. And so you can do it in really simple ways. You can use the veggie meats if you like that sort of thing. You can cook up a big bean soup. And there are plenty of different options. But it's really easy to get every single one of the essential amino acids on an entirely plant-based diet.